meeting with the presence of God, let us commit ourselves in kindness and simplicity to work and pray for freedom and justice, for reconciliation between people and nations, for a world where all may live in peace. Let us confess to God the sins and shortcomings of the world, its pride, its selfishness, its greed, its divisions and hatreds. Let us confess our share in what is wrong, and our failure to seek and establish that peace which God wills for all God's children. Most merciful God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen.
Almighty God, who is all forgiveness, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
The first reading is taken from the book of the prophet Malachi. See, the day is coming, burning like an oven, when all the arrogant and all evildoers will be stubble. The day that comes shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts, so that it will leave them neither root nor branch. But for you, who revere my name, the Sun of Righteousness shall rise with healing in its wings. You shall go out leaping like calves from the stall. This is the word of the Lord.
The second reading is taken from Paul's second letter to the Thessalonians. Now we command you, beloved, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to keep away from believers who are living in idleness and not according to the tradition that they received from us. For you yourselves know how you ought to imitate us. We were not idle when we were with you, and we did not eat anyone's bread without paying for it. But with toil and labor we worked night and day, so that we might not burden any of you. This was not because we do not have that right, but in order to give you an example to imitate. For even when we were with you, we gave you this command: anyone unwilling to work should not eat. For we hear that some of you are living in idleness, mere busybodies, not doing any work. Now such persons we command and exhort in the Lord Jesus Christ to do their work quietly and to earn their own living. Brothers and sisters, do not be weary in doing what is right. This is the word of the Lord.
Beware that you are not led astray. not be terrified. For these things must take place first, but the end will not follow immediately. Then he said to them, nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes, and in various places famines and plagues, and there will be dreadful portents and great signs from heaven. But before all this occurs, they will arrest you and persecute you. They will hand you over to synagogues and prisons. You will be brought before kings and governors because of my name. This will give you an opportunity to testify. So make up your minds, not to prepare your defense in advance. For I will give you words and a wisdom that none of your opponents will be able to withstand or contradict. You will be betrayed even by parents and brothers, by relatives and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name. But a hair of your head will perish. By your endurance you will gain your souls. This is the gospel of the Lord. Our healthcare services, our families, our places of work,
schools. Who are the people that are simply helping to make us feel better, making us smile, or keeping us hopeful? Thinking about heroes in your life today, we can say thank you when you get a chance to meet them. But how can we be heroes ourselves? How can we be kind to people that our grandchildren and our great-grandchildren will look back and say thank you and well done to the people who fought in wars and our time? But it's not easy, is it, when every day seems to bring more bad news? When you try to make plans and you have to tear up again? When you can't bring people who you love? When you can't do all things that you love? When half the time the media say we're getting things right, and of course the other half we're getting it wrong. But if we're going to be an ordinary person doing any kind of extraordinary things, then I'm going to need some serious backup. I'm going to need God, and so we all need God. It's hard to believe in God in a world that looks so very bad right now. But what Jesus was saying is that God takes power and effects in us when we turn to Him and ask Him to be kinder and braver and stronger. He's to lead us in the right direction. But can we extraordinary things with ordinary people like us today? But right now the world needs more heroes. People are ready to make a big effort, an extraordinary effort, to move us from a bad place to a good place. We need children who are kinder at school, who use social media to spread inspiring and funny things, rather than being angry or nasty. We need families who take care of each other, and we need respect for each other. We need people working faithfully in their jobs, and who can be here and how they can. We need people who will smile cheerfully and exchange greetings, even from a distance. We need everybody to be careful, and of course to respect the rules and those restrictions we have in our lives. We need to encourage each other's faith in this community. It sounds very ordinary, but there will be many days when it will take that extraordinary effort, and then we will be reminded to be a hero. But today we're honouring the men and women of past and present wars who became heroes by doing extraordinary things to save their homes, their families, the nation and the world. And we thank God for their heritage. But let us ask Him to make us heroes of our time, moment by moment, day by day. But can anything separate us from God's love? Asked St. Paul when he has gone through a bad time. Can trouble or hardship or hunger or persecution or danger or violence? No, even in the face of all these things, we are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ, who loves us all. So this remembrance day, we are all heroes, and may God bless you and for the years to come. Amen.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Tonight. Let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts, Let us pray for the coming of the kingdom in the words and saving gifts. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We pray this prayer to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we are shared.
Thank you.
Son Jesus Christ proclaimed the kingdom and bestowed the perfect wholeness of life. Look with compassion on the anguish of the world, and by your healing power, make whole both people and nations through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Before we do our act of remembrance, we just have a few notices from St. Peter's. Edna, who was 102 last Thursday, still living in her flat, gives a great thank you to you all for her birthday card and for the flowers for the Mother's Union. Doug and everyone else who's involved, it is our Christmas fair in 2 weeks' time, on the 26th of November. For any donations, full bottles of wine or water and anything else that you're able to give. There are the flyers and the posters in the parish centre. They've got street names on, so if you're able to take some and deliver them to some houses on your street, please do. The more people that know about it, the more people will enter through the doors. And Junior Church will be back next Sunday at 10:30. And for those children who might not have been there, St. Peter, who they did last week, is up stuck on the wall in the centre over there. So thank you all for joining us this morning. Let us remember before God and commend to his sure keeping those who have died for their country in war, those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of humanity.
They shall grow not old as we could to let grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years come dead.
We will remember them. contain our prayers of thanksgiving for all whom you remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love, and bring us all with them to your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrows we gave our today.
Let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace? Will you seek to heal the wounds of war? Will you work for a just future for all humanity? Let us pledge ourselves anew to the service of God and of our brothers and sisters, that we may help, encourage and comfort others, and support those working for the relief of the needy and for the peace and welfare of the nations. Lord God our Father, we pledge ourselves to serve you and all humankind in the cause of peace, for the relief of want and suffering, and for the praise of your name. Guide us by your Spirit. Give us wisdom, give us courage, give us hope, and keep us faithful now and always. Amen.
Thank you.